هاي موافقا.
فول مي ايفريوير يا جو. ماذا يقول امير المؤمنين لدعاة تحرير المرأة الذين ظلوا ينتقدون الاسلام من جانب تعدد الزوجات؟ مور ذان فول
Yes, Amir al-Mu'mineen, you know this is the critical point. Always you find this question yes. everywhere. What would you I say to those who criticize Islam that he permits marriage up to four?
As you were saying, up to four, that gentleman raised his hand and said,
Trap. I was
amazed. I was wondering which religion is referring to, which permits five wives, not four. What he meant was 5 minutes left. So the issue of four wives cannot be determined within 5 minutes. That is the warning. But number one, remember this. It is wrong to say it was a permission, while the practice of the Arabs were that they were stuck to one wife. It's a restriction, because the practice of the Arabs were to even have hundreds of wives. So it was not a permission from one to four, it was a restriction from hundreds to four. And that restriction was further restricted by two warnings on either side. وَإِنْ خِفْتُمْ أَلَّا تُخْسِتُوا يَا لَا تَعْدَلُوا. There is one word qist used and one word other.
Is لَا تَعْدِلُوا حُضُرُ. The second one, لَا تَعْدِلُوا. This is the two sides there.
And the first one is أن تقصدوا في اليتامى.
Yes.
These two conditions on both sides press the person who is thinking of remarrying that you will be permitted, but remember you are answerable to God. Unless you are 100% sure that you will be able to do justice to the women you are marrying, you are not permitted. So the justice is stressed so much that even if a very few people in fact marry among Muslims more than once, they fail to do justice. We can see that. So it's a weakness of man which has been pointed out. For the sake of doing justice, sometimes it is needed that you are permitted to marry twice or three times. When there is a state of war, when there are so many orphans, etc. Or in situations of disease, so many other reasons, when justice demands, you must marry. When the justice prohibits you to marry, stop. This is the most beautiful injunction which meets some national situations, a national crisis, like world wars, World War I, World War II. You know, it left the ratio between men and women in America, in Europe, so disturbed and so imbalanced that in Germany the number of men were less by 1-to-4 ratio, in fact. If you don't permit them to marry twice, you know what you're talking about? Then you say, do whatever you like. Even destroy the home, peace of homes of those who are married. Because so many women in the streets without any strong moral inhibitions stopping them from playing havoc with other people's homes will do this. And this is why every war saw a deep step down in moral values in Europe. There's such a strong kink downwards that the thinkers and intellectuals say this. After the war, the moral standards was nowhere the same as it used to be prior to the war, because of this. In their religion, they don't have this opportunity, this provision for meeting the challenge of the time, like the Holy Quran makes it very clear. Right?
يقول أمير المؤمنين عندما كان السؤال يطرح ويقول أربع زوجات رفع المخرج يده هكذا وخمسة فقال ما هذا هل ارتفع العدد وصاروا خمسة أي دين هذا الذي يسمح بخمسة وهو يقول باقي خمس دقائق يقول أمير المؤمنين أن التعبير بأن الإسلام يسمح بالزواج حتى أربعة هذا تعبير غير صحيح الواقع أنه لم يسمح وإنما هو قلل أو حصر العدد كان قبل الإسلام الزواج غير محدود، تتزوج المرأة عشرات أو كما يشاء، فحدد الإسلام هذا الانفتاح وقيده بأربعة، فليس كانوا يتزوجون واحدة ثم سمح الإسلام بأربعة، لا، كانوا يتزوجون العشرات فقيده الإسلام بأربعة. ومع ذلك وضع حاجزين، الحاجز الأول إن خفتم ألا تقسطوا في اليتامى فانكحوا، إذن الزواج بأكثر من واحدة حتى أربعة للإقساط للقسط، وإن خفتم ألا تعدلوا فواحدة، إذن الواحدة للعدل وأكثر من واحدة للقسط. متى يحدث هذا؟ إذا حدثت الحروب وحدثت المشاكل التي تتعرض لها الرجال وينقص عددهم وتصبح نسبتهم أقل من النساء، أين تذهب هذه النساء؟ من العدل ومن القسط إليهم أن يتزوجن. لا.